Welcome to Gethsemane Lutheran Church for our Sunday morning worship service. Our mission is to be engaged by God in a living faith, at home, at church, and in the world. And we hope that through these services, we help you to be part of that mission. We encourage you to connect with us through our website at glconline.org and let us know how we can help you on your journey. Now, let us worship together. Welcome to worship at Gethsemane. Today we are celebrating Reformation Sunday, and I can honestly say that there has been no time within my lifetime that the church has been doing more reforming than it is right now. As we've been forced to have all of our services and education online, as we have important conversations about topics like race, gender, sexual identity, and the climate, we are doing the work of the Reformation. As usual, we are offering our confirmation services today on Reformation Sunday. It's going to be a private service, and it'll be recorded so that you can see and participate in it at a later date. But you will see pictures and hear a bit of the journeys of the students that are being confirmed later today. You are invited to join me in prayer each Wednesday night, anytime between 4:30 and 6 o'clock in the sanctuary, or wherever it is you happen to be at that time. Together we are the church, and that includes praying with and for one another, for the world, and for all people in need. Our need of the month is ICA, and we are collecting winter warm wear for our community. The most needed items are new waterproof gloves and hats, new or gently used winter jackets, especially in large sizes and styles for teens. If you prefer to make a financial donation, those dollars will be used to help fill in the gaps so that everyone gets what they need and can stay warm this winter. Next Sunday is our next outdoor worship service, and it is also All Saints' Day. At both our recorded service and our outdoor service, we will be remembering the members of Gethsemane family who have passed away this past year. There will be candle lighting and the ringing of the bell as we remember those saints, but also all of the others that guide us in life and in light. We are continuing to monitor the safety of our building and our programs as we go through this COVID time. And for now, we know that it is the safest to continue worshiping virtually. Even though we do not see each other on a regular basis, we care about you and for you. If you have a prayer concern for yourself or a loved one, please let us know by emailing or calling the church office. Together, we are the church.
Thank you. help in times of trouble.
We will not fear.
Though the earth be moved and the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea,
we will not fear.
Though nations rage and kingdoms fall,
we will not fear.
There is a river, the streams of which make glad the city of God.
God is in the midst of earth.
Be still and know, be still.
Be still and know that I am God.
Amen.
The gospel for today comes from John chapter 8, verses 31 through 36. Then Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." They answered him, "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying you will be made free?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The Son has a place there forever. So if the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed."
Reformation Sunday has long been a day when we lift up not only the heritage of the Lutheran Reformation, but more importantly, the worldview that was laid open for all Christian believers so many years ago. Many think that the Reformers presented a doctrine in which the church should be structured by. But more importantly, what they laid out was the possibility of a new way of viewing one's relationship with God and with our neighbor. It has less to do with the church and what the church thought, and more to do with us and what we thought about God. When one thinks about Reformation theology, they will often lean towards scripture readings like Ephesians 2:8. "For it is by grace that you have been saved through faith and not the result of works." Fine, heady stuff, for sure, if you're trying to figure out how you're going to get to heaven someday. But it presupposes an interest or a relationship that you might have with God. I mean, why would you even want to go be with God with someone you don't know? Who is in heaven, and why would you want to be there? That's why that the scripture text that was actually assigned for today comes from John 8, where Jesus tells those who believed in him, "If you continue in my word, if you dwell in that word, you will be my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." Freedom, we know. Freedom, we like. It's our natural instinct and our national motto. After all, we are living in the land of the free. You could say that we are not slaves to anyone, but are we? The freedom that Jesus is talking about here is not simply being free from sin, but actually being free to enter in to a relationship with God through our own connections. Luther once said that Christians were free from all things so that no one can determine your relationship with God or our future with God. But at the same time, we're bound to one another and to the well-being and the advancement of our neighbor. That's why we celebrate the confirmation of all of our youth on this day, our Reformation Sunday. Exactly because Luther laid out that you don't have to believe exactly as I believe, and you're free to have a relationship with God as God has made you. But, as you know, there always is a but you're still obligated to the community and to me and to your neighbor next door. You don't get to take your own belief and go run off by yourself. Together, we are the church, free from all things and bound to everyone. I invite you to listen to the testimonies of all of our confirmants as they each were asked to describe their unique journey of faith in their final essays before they were confirmed. Carl Eichenberg wrote, "I definitely identify with God the Father as the creator of everything. I try my best to believe God is real and see God as a light in the darkness. It feels good to have a protector by my side. I felt especially close to God when I was at Green Lake Bible Camp and as a young child, and I became super homesick. I prayed to God to help me and was greatly comforted. I got through it and all was good. I find great comfort in my confirmation small group, also, where we can talk amongst things together. Calvin Anderson wrote, "Truly, I'm really grateful to have had this community, and I'm grateful for all the experiences that have shaped me and made me who I am as a person." I think the verse from the Bible that echoes this is Jeremiah 29:11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." I think this is really an important message. Everyone has a future, and sure, we may have bad times, but there will be good times. Faith, also known as Jasper Lamser, wrote, "I will admit that I'm happy when I go to church because of the relationships that I've made there and the people that I've grown up with. The church continues to be a second home for me. I find comfort in the familiar places with familiar people." When asked about my favorite verse, I've chosen Proverbs 4:23, which says, "Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it." I like this because it reminds me that I don't need someone to tell me what I should or shouldn't do or think. It can flow from my heart. Joe Cratley wrote, "I know that God exists. There has to be something beyond the world we are in now, and I believe that is intrinsic to the existence of God. I do believe that there's a presence that guides people through the faith and provides clarity when it comes to it. One of the things I think that brings me closer to God is when I do readings in church. It has shown me something I very much enjoy, talking in front of large groups, but it will be my own, whether it be my own words or those of the Bible. I believe that through doing readings at church, it helps me embrace talking to people about God and knowing the abilities I have to change my perspectives of my future." Andrew Yakes wrote, "When I was younger, I used to treat coming to church like a hobby, and I was forced to show up. Now I show up as a treat, not just because of COVID, but even before that, I would say it was the most peaceful and fun time of my week. Over the years, we've learned so much from church, like the amazing stories of Jesus and his disciples. God helped us all and has impacted each and every day of our lives. I know for sure God helps me. Like before every sports game, I might reach out to God for help." The verse I chose that I believe represents my faith path comes from Mark 10:27. "Jesus looked at them and said, 'With man it is impossible, but not with God, for all things are possible with God.'" The reason I chose this quote is because I know where I don't know where I would be without God. Without him, I don't think I would be nearly as strong or as courageous. Wilton Bomsta wrote, "My grandparents were pretty religious, and they taught me a lot about Jesus and God. I doubt that without them or my friend Andrew, who invited me to church, I would have ever joined confirmation, and I'm glad I did. Confirmation has taught me so many new things about being Lutheran and showing me something that I would never have seen before. I personally believe that Jesus Christ loves everyone for who they are. I believe this because Jesus sacrificed so much for us and has given us a great life. I also believe that Jesus is forgiving and understands that everyone sins and always forgives us for that. I also believe that Jesus Christ is someone who will always be there for you and you can always talk to." Ben Shuby wrote, "One Bible verse that sums up where I am at in my faith is, 'And Jesus answered and said, You unbelieving and perverting generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I put up with you? Bring him here to me.' I'm still at a point where I have not felt a strong connection to God, but I currently only have a small amount of faith. But at the end, where it states, 'Bring him here,' is a path I'm on. I'm on my way to creating that connection and believing, and I'm getting closer to understanding the purpose behind this world and creation. Although I may struggle to understand heaven and the afterlife, I'll always put myself in places to try and feel a connection and understand more to grow in my faith. That's why I chose the verse from the Isaiah 41, "Fear not, for I am with you." Dominic Zisca wrote, "In my short life, I've always been a person who believes in God, but I have changed my opinion of who God is. I don't believe he will always answer how you want him to. I don't believe anymore that he will give you what you think you want him to give you, but I believe he will show you what you initially thought was important in your life may not be, and may suddenly change how he shows you and teaches you to learn from that. I believe God is intangible, but also that he affects me by being an invisible force and influences in the resources around me. I think he also has a plan for me and guides my path. God teaches me and fosters me to become a human that will influence others the same way that he has influenced me." Will Spangrude wrote, "I believe there is someone or even always something that looks out for us and watching out for us in this world. I can look back at so much that has happened in my life, such as my own adoption story. I know someone was watching over me when I was in that orphanage because they made sure I was safe and put into a family with lots of love, which I'm so thankful for. I also believe that everything happens for a reason, like the reason why I was adopted by my mother. I would have never got to meet this amazing church family through her. This higher power brings people together. It doesn't just help us see our path. It helps lead us to one another, to build a connection based on our faith and create a community that will last. The closest thing I had to an aha moment was when I was in the Boundary Waters. After dinner one night, we were sitting and laughing and singing and talking and looking out over the beautiful scenery, reminiscing about stories we shared from Sunday school and vacation Bible school, Green Lake, all when we were younger. And that's when it hit me, that my faith is heavenly surrounded by this community. I grew up in this church and these people since the time I was 3. And without this community and this family, I wouldn't be where I am now. I know I will always have this family watching over me. Be it 10 years in the future, I have questions or struggles in faith, I may need a little bit of guidance, and I can come back to the church to answer that. Ellen Johanning wrote, "Throughout my journey as a confirmation student in Gethsemane, I've learned a lot. I'm continuing to grow in my faith and believe that God has a plan for each and every one of us, and that he's put us on this earth to live for him and experience his presence around us. God loves me and loves you. He wants me to love myself along with him and others as well. I believe that Jesus died for our sins. I believe in the Holy Spirit is a belief in the truth in me, the belief of a promise of another helper who teaches and reminds me of who I am. I felt such a strong connection to God in the Boundary Waters with my confirmation group. It was an amazing experience, unlike any other trip I've ever been on in my life. It was a whole new journey. It gave me an opportunity to meet people that I had never met before. Every day I saw God in the beautiful nature around us, in the trees, in the water, the sun, the people, everything that made it so such a beautiful creation, even the time that I fell in that gross swamp. For God, nothing shall be impossible," Luke wrote in chapter 1, verse 37. It's a verse I chose because it makes me feel like I can have comfort in God. Wherever I go, whatever challenge I face, I know that God will be there with me, and there's nothing I cannot do. Amanda Barnes wrote, "Over the years, my viewpoint of God has changed. When I was younger, I never really put much thought into it. I had always assumed God would just be somewhere far off in the world and never connect with me personally. I also had a basic knowledge of the Bible and Scripture, but now that I've had a chance to reflect, to listen and learn, this is what I think. God's different for everyone. The Bible has really helped me to learn how more about Scripture and God and inspires me. I love writing, and so reading all the stories in the Bible get me my creative juices flowing. The verse I chose comes from 1 Corinthians in the 16th chapter. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be courageous and strong. Do everything in love. I think that combines everything that I value. I want to be courageous and strong in my life, but most of all, I will make sure that I do everything in love. I believe nothing will get you further in life than just being loving and kind to all. Anna Hepperlin wrote, I've always been a little skeptical of religion, not God or the Holy Spirit, just the Bible. When I was a little girl, I used to make my dad come into my room and I would quiz him on the Bible. I would ask him things like how he knew that it wasn't a bunch of made-up stories and that people told to influence others, or why it was important in the first place. He would always answer something along the lines of, well, you just have to believe. To a very curious little girl like me, that was not the answer I was looking for. I want facts. And yet over the years, I realized there's no way of knowing. You just have to trust. I can say without a doubt that I have never heard God, but I've come to realize that there are times when it's like there's someone else there, almost looking over me. I can feel the Holy Spirit. For me, it's like rain, and I love rain. I love the sound of the rain dropping from trees, hitting an umbrella, the smell of the moss when it's raining, and it's just amazing how anything could be so magical. That's what I feel the Holy Spirit is like, and God reminding me of it. Kate Yecca wrote, I personally believe that the Holy Trinity is one of the most major things in my faith. They all represent something different, but they all are God at the core. I like the thought that at the core of everyone is that same goodness. We're all just experiencing and doing things a little different. In my faith journey, I've made a couple roadblocks, just like everyone. And like many others, I struggle with the fact that God isn't tangible or visible. And it's especially hard because everyone likes to have proof. It's a challenge to learn to trust and believe. And that's why we call it faith. It's just about reassuring yourself with the Bible and listening to the valuable lessons. Even when your beliefs or your faith hits a roadblock, and you can look at the Bible and the pathways for morals, I just feel it guides the messages and lets us guide us back to our faith. My favorite verse that I have connected with is from Romans 15. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. This verse talks about trusting in God, how it gives you peace. And the more you put your trust in God, the more peace and joy he fills with you. I share these testimonies with you to encourage you in your own walk of faith. We are all at different points in our faith journey, and we each testify to a God in different ways, but we each have been blessed with a relationship through Jesus Christ. And as Jesus said, when we dwell in his word, when we abide in the truth that God comes to us in many ways, that truth is what sets us free to be the amazing and beautiful creation God has made us to be. And for that, I give thanks. Amen.
With confidence in God's grace and mercy, let us pray for the church, the world, and all of those in need. O God, we ask for renewal and inspiration as we seek the freedom of the gospel. Where the church is in error, provide reform. Where the church speaks your truth, give strength. And where the church is divided, bring unity. Ignite in us the working of the Holy Spirit. Make us courageous voices that remain firm in our commitment to truth and freedom. May we seek justice, love mercy, and love one another. We pray for our partner congregation, Iglesia Concordia, unify us in the hope of the gospel, and keep our partnership centered in Christ's love. As the earth spins and the seasons change, may we learn to care for this planet as a holy habitation for all living things. Provide sustenance, employment, and health for all peoples. Bring back to life the communities recovering from fires and flooding. Give strength to the healthcare workers and all who are working to bring healing to those affected by the coronavirus. Be with those who mourn the loss of a loved one, those who are without food or a living wage, and those who are not safe. Protect all who are in harm's way and guide us as we work to find a treatment for this virus. Guide our country, divided and traumatized by a pandemic, systemic racism, and a contentious election season. Ease the conflict among those with differing opinions, especially in our own country, state, and city. Bring us together for the betterment of all. We pray for our youth who are confirmed today. May they walk humbly with you, be centered in your grace, enfolded in your arms, and surrounded by your love. Many of us are struggling with uncertainties. We feel helpless and alone. Remind us of your unfaltering love and our need to surrender our worries. We ask for release for those living in bondage to debt, fear, illness, chronic pain, abusive relationships, or addiction. Grant your healing touch to all. We pray especially today for all those we name within our hearts. Gracias a Dios por mi iglesia y mis pastores.
Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. And now let us pray together the words our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
God has shown you what is good.
What does the Lord require of you?
But to do justice,
to love kindness,
and to walk humbly with your God.
And now may the love of God,
grace of Jesus Christ,
and the communion of the Holy Spirit
be with you all. Amen.